Hi everybody, what's up? What's good? I'm really pleased today to be able to talk with you guys about karma. Let's talk about some karma and how karma means action. And I kind of decided because one's just a little idea that's a little bit complicated that some people might not understand is in the Bhagavad Gita, and in other places in Hindu religion, it talks about how karma is action and how the enlightened person will realize how even someone who is not moving can be performing actions, and how even one who is moving might not be performing actions. But in order to understand what is a true action, you have to understand what karma is, because karma means action. So I'm going to try to explain this as best I can in a nutshell. So let's say someone is, like, I'm sitting here. Let's say I was not doing anything, but like I was not talking, moving, or anything. But someone who is enlightened will realize that even inaction has a consequence, right? Even inaction is not true inaction. And I mean physical inaction. I don't mean true inaction, which means no karma or no action. I mean like no physical activity. So the enlightened person will realize how even not doing a physical activity can incur karma and has a consequence. On the other hand, you have the enlightened person who goes around performing deeds without desiring of their results, which would mean that they are not incurring karma, which means they're actually not performing any actions at all, in the context of the universe. So that means that their actions are only positive and beneficial, and they're not disrupting the karmic flow. You know what I mean? Like, so they're not desiring the results of their actions when they perform these actions. And so by not desiring the results of their actions, which would be desiring, you know, the karma to occur, therefore you do not incur karma because you are not desiring for that karma to come about. You're just doing good deeds for the sake of doing good deeds. So that is how even someone who is performing physical actions like charity or penance or religious service, they are actually they're performing a physical action, but they're not performing a spiritual karmic action, if that makes sense, because they're not putting out a ripple into the karma. And since karma means action, they are not creating any actions in the universe by creating that ripple, because they're not doing it because they want to create a ripple. They're doing it because it is the positive structure of the universe, and the positive structure of the universe and God already exists. So you cannot create a ripple by aligning with God. Does that make sense? Because God already exists, and God is already the structure and the fabric of the universe. So by aligning yourself with God and the fabric of the universe, you cannot create karma or a karmic ripple in the universe by doing good deeds and actions like that. But that's also why someone who sits there and doesn't do anything good and doesn't contribute to the structure of God in the universe and the structure of the universe in a positive way, you know, they actually are creating a karmic ripple, because maybe they're sitting there and not performing any actions because they know that there's no guarantee that they will get a reward for it, whereas the other person is working and they don't care about the reward, and they're upholding the structure of the universe. And some of this is just kind of my interpretation, my opinion about it, how I made sense of it. you know, because you're supposed to kind of sit there and meditate on these ideas. So obviously, if anyone has anything they want to add or any corrections they want to make, go ahead. These are kind of just in my own words from what I've researched and read. But that is kind of, I hope, helping you guys understand what karma actually is and how karma actually means action. And when we talk about actions, it's not always a physical action. Just how when we talk about yoga, it's not always physical, you know, it's also a spiritual thing. It's not always like a physical activity. You know, you need to open your mind to these other ways of thinking about topics, because just because you've thought about a topic or an idea in one way your whole life, that doesn't mean that there isn't, you know, another way to think about it, or that you are thinking about it the proper way. Because maybe, you know, the action, like, that's the whole thing, is when you think about karma, people think about it in a very strange way that does not actually align with what karma actually is. And it's really hard for people to actually understand, I feel like, at least Western people, to understand what karma is, because they're not, like, you know, or to understand this whole idea that the universe can be created and uncreated at the same time, that something can be real and an illusion at the same time. Because if you're not brought up with these topics and with these ideas, it's hard to sometimes incorporate them into your already pre-existing paradigm, I guess you would want to say. So I hope that that kind of helped you understand a little bit, like, what people mean by karma and mean by action. So if you're ever reading or listening to or researching these texts in any way, or researching Hinduism, and you come across the concept of karma, or maybe if it's still confusing you a little bit, because I know I have another video explaining what it is, but I don't know if it's, you know, super great, very well said or anything. But that's just another, if you want to go see more about it, there you can. But yeah, no. So I hope this kind of helped a little bit clear that up. It's kind of a short video, but I didn't want to make it super long. So thanks for watching. I hope that you will be able, because I'm pretty sure, like, most karma is just, like, you don't want to have karma. You want to resolve your karma so that you can, like, you know, escape the cycle of rebirth. But, you know, like I said, if I'm wrong about anything, if you want to add anything, if you just want to say hi, if you want to tell a cool story, you know, leave it in the comments. And if you guys actually like videos like this, then go ahead and like and subscribe, because that tells me that someone actually wants more content like this. So, but I'm going to put out more content like this anyway. So also, if you just want stuff like this and want to know stuff like this, little tidbits, or, you know, just want to hear me rant about stuff, go ahead, like and subscribe. I always forget to say that, but it's because I'm the kind of person where I believe that, you know, if somebody likes you, they're just gonna like you anyway. So, and that's how I feel. Like, I don't want you guys to like and subscribe just because I told you to. I want you to because it's your choice, okay? So that's the, I'll say that too, is if you don't want to like and you don't want to subscribe, if you want to dislike and you want to unsubscribe, do you, bruh. Do you. Achieve your dreams, damn it. All right. I'll see you guys later. I'll see ya. Narwhal pushing. We'll see y'all later.